him. I played against Rapport a very long time ago. I was with the black pieces and I did not know the theory, unfortunately. Position, I believe Queen D8 is already a mistake, and I believe black should play something like Queen F5 in this position. So we can compare this with the thing of the French position that we discussed, that black took with the queen on d5 and then went back to d8, losing time. And that's what I did as well, so it looked very safe to me, but actually it's not safe. And I mean, the position is symmetrical, so black has no pawn weaknesses. I need a few moves, just play some rook c8, queen c7, rook d8, and I have zero problems, obviously. So white has to react in a concrete way to gain any kind of advantage, and he did. So he played really according to this, trying to gain initiative and try to use this dynamic factor. So he took on c5. Obviously, if I would take with the pawn, then he gains a lot because of this isolated pawn on c5. So all endgames are very bad for me. So of course I do not take with the pawn. I took with the bishop. And again, he's keeping me busy with knight e5. So now the problem is that, I took e5. Of course, I don't want to give up the pair of bishops, but the problem is that, for example, if I play something like queen c7, I believe he can just take with the knight. Bishop c6, so again capture, bishop c6, and then threaten mate in one. And this position looks pretty unpleasant. So f5, then he can take probably queen g7. So if I take back, it's a pawn down. If I take here also, it's going to be pawn down. And I'm not even sure that this is the best white can do. Maybe some knight d7 actually also possible. If I move the rook, then he is playing queen g4, and yeah, I mean, this is extremely scary. So I took on e5, but he already managed to gain the pair of bishops with this nice play, and also the knight is hanging right now, so it's very, very unpleasant for me. And again, we have to know that it would be nice to play some queen c7 move, but again, check, and the capture on h7 is winning the game for white because of bishop takes d5. So I cannot do this. I mean, okay, what can I do? I mean, I can play knight g6, right? I mean, that's... But it was a horrible move to make, to be honest. So, because the knight is very bad on g6, white can play h4, h5. And this bishop is completely dominating the board. So it's definitely a very unpleasant position. And okay, we speak about material. White has the pair of bishops in an open position. So it's clear advantage for white. So I did not play knight g6. I mean, what is the point of knight g6? I mean, the point of knight g6 is that I play knight g6 and that's it. So I don't need other move with my knight, it's already on the square I wanted to put it. But I played knight d7. And my idea is that I want to put my knight on f6, where it's 100 times better than on g6. And also controls d7 entry square, and also blocks the diagonal. So in this, positional sense, I mean, it's a much better move than knight g6. The problem is that instead of one move, I need two moves in this position, sorry. And he could have taken advantage of this this thing. He played queen e2, and the game eventually ended in a draw after some knight f6, bishop g2, queen e7, and I managed to play later a5 to stabilize this bishop, and then rook d8, and even though I was under some pressure, but it was never really dangerous for me. So what is the correct move? So again, we try to look for some... Black needs one more move. So we try to look for some forcing options to keep black under the pressure. So we have different options for these, like queen h5, but then f5 is coming. Basically any move when we try to attack h7, black plays f5 and knight f6. It's not so bad. Queen g4 doesn't really work because I just play knight f6. g7, h7 cannot really be attacked this way. But there is one more move which is a threat, and it's very unpleasant. It's b4. Again, a pawn move, attacking the bishop, and if I capture on b4, actually I can just resign after queen d4 because of this double attack here. So it was not possible to take, so that means that I have one move. So I have to play bishop e7, I don't have any counter attack. And after queen a4, I mean, my position is extremely bad. So the point is that, you know, the line that I played in the game, like knight f6, queen e7, I mean, it was possible because my bishop was on c5, and now the rooks are... So for example, knight f6, rook d1, queen c7, rook c1, and my queen is trapped. So there are such lines here. So basically b4 was almost like a winning move here. I mean, I believe after bishop e7, queen a4, I mean, I have some move here, but it's... Whatever I do, it's plus minus, so somehow I have to sacrifice a7 pawn, maybe with bishop f6, I'm not so sure, but the position is super bad. So this b4 he missed, but it's a logical move since I was missing one move with knight f6. So I mean, also we have to conclude that even though it's, I mean, this is what I want, I mean, simply the time was not there. So good or bad, I had to play knight g6 and try to hope for, you know, for some defense in this position.